Well, hello everyone, and welcome back to the Connected Franchise Series with the Cincinnati Bengals. And we're going to rebuild them, and we're going to take them all the way to the top and hopefully get them to be Super Bowl champions, because they're one of the remaining teams that are still not Super Bowl champions. We're going to fix that here today. But like I said before, guys, if you haven't already, leave a like on this video and subscribe to the channel if you're new. I would really appreciate it, and let's get started. So first off, this is going to be the trade portion of the video. What we got to do is we gotta try and make our team better, and that starts with the trades. So what we're gonna do is we gotta see what positions we need to upgrade and make sure that we can make those trades and get those players that we need to be successful and hopefully be Super Bowl champions. So I was looking at receiver. We need a second receiver. 74 overall at receiver number 2 is not gonna cut it. Sorry, Tyler Boyd, I'm just sorry. And I was thinking offensive line, it needs some help. Right tackle, this man right here, I was looking at Andre Smith. He's 31, he's kind of old. 74 isn't going to cut it. This man also, 70 overall. He is kind of young, so maybe we could trade him away, get some bait for him. I don't know. And yeah, Baker Mayfield, he's part of the Cincinnati Bengals. Remember Blake Pace? Well, guess what? It wasn't Blake Pace. It was really Baker Mayfield the whole time. Just Madden was stupid, and it didn't recognize it was Baker Mayfield. That's why he was going off. Baker Mayfield is now on our team, Cincinnati Bengals. And, yeah, he is looking to take over Andy Dalton's spot here in the series. So, hopefully you guys are going to enjoy that. And we're going to try and look to trade away Andy Dalton sometime this season and maybe even soon. So, we don't know yet, but like I said, we need to make improvements. So I was thinking right tackle. We get somebody at right tackle because this guy isn't going to cut it. We're going to see if anybody wants a right tackle named Andre Smith. We're going to look right tackle. So Broncos' number one need is right tackle, but I don't know if we could trade him away. Like, I'll try for a 4th round pick. See if we could get some picks for this man. And yeah. Their number one team need is right tackle, and he's so old that they don't want him. So I don't know if we can trade him away. But in the meantime, we're going to look for teams that have a pretty solid right tackle. And here we go, right tackle. We're going to look for the best available right tackle we need to get this team rolling. And all these guys are old so far, and none of them are in the 90s. Oh, I skipped somebody. Cowboys, he's 77 overall. That's a surprise. Lane Johnson could be a man we might target. We'll look at him later. But he's on the list. Bobby Hart, screw you. All these guys are pretty bad, to be honest. Yeah. So, Lane Johnson might be the man. Because he's 91 overall. And I know we don't have that much cap, but maybe we could try and trade for him. So let's go back to the Eagles, which is right here. Lane Johnson, right tackle, 91 overall. One of the best right tackles, is the best right tackle in this game. And they need a middle linebacker. Is there a middle linebacker that we could trade away that we don't need? No, Bobby Wagner we got on the last episode, so that's a no-no. Vontaze Burfict, we're going to keep him. He's 27 years old. I don't think they would want this man, but we could try. Yeah, that's going nowhere. Let's see what else we could do. So, would they be interested in the man, Andy Dalton, who has 11 million? All right, but they have Carson Wentz, so I don't think that's going to be a solution at this time. Kevin Hogan, maybe. Let's see, all right, this trade might go through, because Kevin Hogan, we don't need him, and it's already halfway through, and it's in the yellow, about to be green, and that's already good. I'm liking this deal already. So Kevin Hogan, we got plenty of running backs. Somebody needs to be cut, and I don't know. But Joe Mixon, Jeremy Hill, Giovanni Bernard. I like all three of them. But we can make the running back position even better in future trades. So Jeremy Hill is a big cap hit, but I don't know if I want to trade him to the Eagles. You know what I'm saying? Giovanni Bernard is 26. Jeremy Hill's 25. And I don't know. We could try and trade Giovanni Bernard away as well. This might go through, so if that does, we're going to be safe and try and get as much out of the steal possible, because why not? We're trying to get as much possible so we could get more things throughout the series. Looks like that's not going to work. If this goes straight up, oh, it's so close. I don't know if I want to trade Giovanni Bernard, but we could find somebody else they might like Tyler Boyd. Like I said, I want to get rid of him. This would go through. I'll be giving up all these guys for Lane Johnson, but I think that's a smart decision because he's a good player. So let's just try this straight up, and I think we're going to get Lane Johnson. There we go. We do get the main man, Lane Johnson, at our right tackle position. That is a player we did need, and we got that. So that is one step closer to helping us be Super Bowl champions. Now, like I said, now we have John Ross at receiver, too. We're going to keep him. He looks like to be a fan favorite of the Cincinnati Bengals. But other than that, we need another receiver. So we're going to try and look for another receiver before we do anything this episode. So receiver 2. Who could be a good receiver 2? So let's take a look at receivers. Cameron Meredith is not a man I would want. I want to try and get somebody in like high 80s, low 90s. If that's possible. Mike Evans is 90 overall, and we don't have enough cap for him. Larry Fitzgerald, he's too old. Keenan Allen, a man we could target. I like him a lot at 26 years old, but he does have too. He's gonna ruin our cap. Tyreek Hill, this might be a man. Do we pick up Tyreek Hill? He has zero cap hit, and I don't know what we would trade away for him. They need a free safety, so. George Iloka, he's a 3.5 cap hit. Maybe they do want him. So let's just try this straight up, and it's almost halfway, which is good. They also need a left end. Carlos Dunlap, we could trade him away also, because he is 9.85 mil, and that will help us in cap. But do they have enough cap for this? Yes, they do. Both these guys are green. I have a feeling this might go straight up. But in the meantime, let's try and get some picks out of it. Let's see if this will go through. Probably won't, and it's back to being halfway. Now if we just try a third round pick, that's in the yellow. But I just want to try and get as much out of this trade as possible, just because, you know, we're giving up two of our players that were starters for Tyreek Hill. I know it's a lot, but this helps our cap room a lot, because this guy's worth a 9 million, and this guy's worth 3.5 million. So that will definitely help us out. We'll have 17.7 in cap if we do this. So let's just try, and it's not going to go through straight up. So we have to add someone else as well. They do need a middle linebacker, right outside linebacker, and a receiver. Would they like any of our other receivers we have left available? Cody Core, this man was going off in preseason. Now, I don't know. We'll try it though. And they are not interested whatsoever. How about we take a look? We'll come back to this trade, and we'll go in free agency and see who they have that maybe we could trade some of these free agent receivers, possibly. So let's go to free agency, check receivers. Bryce Butler could be a man they want, or this man TJ Jones as well. We'll try and trade both of these guys away. So if we sign this man, Bryce Butler, try and trade him away to the Kansas City Chiefs with Carlos Dunlap and George Iloka. Will it go through, and will we be able to pick up my man Tyreek Hill? So we're going to put the main man, Bryce Butler, in, who we just signed out of free agency, and we're going to put in the main man, George Iloka, who is a 79 overall, worth 3.5 mil in cap, and this is definitely going to help our cap so much, man. Like, you don't understand, guys. Like, this is going to help lots of trades go through. So now we have to go back to the Kansas City Chiefs, and we want Tyreek Hill, a great receiver at 24 years old at a 91 overall, and they don't want him. Alright, they don't want Bryce Butler, so that is not good, but we're going to try and get as much as possible. So we got two 80 overall cornerbacks, Kyle Fuller, DRC, Dre Kirkpatrick. Maybe they want this man. This guy is worth 5.94 in cap. They don't have enough money for him. So we're going to try and, well, I didn't mean to get rid of George Iloka. That is my bad. Let's see who else they could possibly want. So maybe they want my main man, Sean Williams. Would they want him? It doesn't look like it. And trade goes nowhere. We could use a draft pick in this trade. We could do that. Because I could like, this man is definitely going wayside, for sure. Because he is a lot in cap, and he's not even a starter. So, let's go trade. Let's try and do a fifth round pick. See if this goes through. And it's in the green. Now we'll go to the fourth round pick. If that doesn't work, well then, we'll try the second round pick. Fourth, alright, doesn't look like it's going to go through. Now, the second round pick might go through. Just in case, we're going to try and milk everything that we could get out of this trade as possible. So, let's try and get a seventh round pick and see if this does go through. And it does. We get Tyreek Hill for Carlos Dunlap, George Iloka, and a second round pick. And we save a lot in cap, so that is good. And we get a seventh round pick, including Tyreek Hill. Not a bad trade whatsoever. That is a pretty decent trade. And we are back to playing preseason games. And on this episode, we're going to finish the whole preseason. I'm going to make it short and quick, and I'm going to chop everything up. But that was a trade portion. We did get Lane Johnson and Tyreek Hill. So hopefully you guys did enjoy that. And now let's get into the preseason games. And we're going to see who's going to win the quarterback battle between Andy Dalton or Baker Mayfield. See you guys in a quick second. So guys, I decided in this episode we're going to play two preseason games. And we're going to finish the preseason next episode. So hopefully you guys do like that decision by me. And it's second down and three. And Leonard Fournette is going to get the first down and take his way to a 9-yard gain. Blake Bortles is sacked. My man Johnson with the sack, number 90, making a huge play for us on defense. Well, the Jacksonville Jaguars have been just driving on us as the Cincinnati Bengals defense looks terrible, and TJ Yeldon is going to break a tackle and go all the way for a touchdown. Unbelievable. And we got to fix this in next episode. This defense is pathetic. So pathetic that TJ Yeldon could just run all over us like we're nothing. Well, my man Andy Dalton is coming out and trying to prove that he is still the number one quarterback. And that was a terrible pass by my man. We also need to find out who's going to be the starting running back for the Cincinnati Bengals. So let's see what Joe Mixon has in store for us, and goes nowhere because our offensive line is complete trash. With it being third down and nine, Andy Dalton has to prove that he could be the starting quarterback by making a drive. All right, he did it. Never mind. He is good. 28-yard play. That was beautiful. Andy Dalton is made up for it. I thought he was going to be like throwing a pick or something, but it's all good. With it being 7-0 and the first quarter winding down, and Joe Mixon trying to make a statement, if he wants to be the starting running back, he has to prove that he can, like, be the man. So, we signed Bryce Butler out of free agency just for a trade, and I tried to see if the route would line up and work perfectly, but it didn't, because it didn't develop. Now it's back to third down at 14. Andy Dalton has to show up once again. And we're going to try and throw it to the main man, Butler. And he's going to come down with it. And he's still going. And he's going to be taken down at the 1-yard line. Beautiful play by Andy Dalton and Bryce Butler for the connection. Well, now that the first quarter's over, Baker Mayfield is going to be making his first real, you know, performance here. Because, you know, he showed up. And that was a terrible play by me. That was my bad. That was my bad. So, Baker Mayfield is taking over, and this is like his first real appearance here as a Cincinnati Bengals, because like he just told us that his name wasn't Blake Pace, and he really was Baker Mayfield. I don't know how we didn't find out about that, but it's all good. We're going to look for Tyler Kroft, and my man got sacked. Where is the offensive line? Third and goal. Andy Dalton set us up for this, so, you know, we're trying to do something. Here we go. Baker Mayfield is going to look for A, and it is caught by Tyler Kroft, the second string tight end. And Baker Mayfield showing that he could eventually be the starting quarterback for the Cincinnati Bengals. Well, our defense actually shut down the Jaguars offense and held them to a 3-and-out, and we are back on offense. Jeremy Hill is trying to make a name for himself, and he's going to have a nice gain. Beautiful 17-yard gain for the main man, Jeremy Hill. All right, Baker Mayfield trying to show he is a starter, and it just comes out of the man's hands, and he can't come down with that one. Baker Mayfield, it's 3rd and 19, he's gonna throw it, and the main man Randall is wide open, and is able gonna pick up the first down with ease. Alright, Baker Mayfield is gonna find a man open. Randall drops it in the end zone. That is unbelievable. We're gonna have to go with the field goal. Well, the Jaguars went all the way down the field and scored a touchdown. And that is our defense coming up clutch. And Randall's able to haul that one in. Jeremy Hill is running. And he's going to pick up the first down. Baker Mayfield gets the first down. All right, 12 seconds left. Baker Mayfield trying to show that he's worthy of being the starting quarterback. We're going to try, and it's picked off. Well, that's not looking good on Baker Mayfield's resume whatsoever. With it being 3rd down and inches, we have to run this ball. We have to run this ball. And Carson, my man, is making a name for himself and is going to truck his way down to the 4-yard line. What a beautiful gain, 17 yards over his first snap of this preseason game. Beautiful play. Let's just take a look at this. Look at this. Carrying his way, moving, and trucking defenders, making plays. That's what I like to see, and that's why this guy could be the main man to keep. Like, we got to make these decisions in the offseason. Do we keep this running back? Do we trade him away? And these are all decisions I have to make, and you guys can help as well down in the comment section down below. We're going to give this to Carson again, and he's going to get into the end zone, and this man could be the starting running back. There is question about it. There's now looming questions. Look at this. This guy, 2 plays, like, I know he can't base his whole career off these 2 plays, but let me tell you something. This could be a guy we might keep for the roster, and I might have missed the extra point, but it's all good. No, we didn't. We are up 17-14, and I'll take 2nd down and 8. They're going to fake it. I'm going to try and blitz with Bobby Wagner, and Keenan Cole is off to the races, and I thought he was still going. My man's making some plays, though. I like Keenan Cole. He is a man that could be good for the Jaguars in this AFC Championship coming up against the New England Patriots. How about Tom Brady here in his right hand? That's something funny. That is pretty funny. All right, we're going to hurt TJ. Sit down, TJ. All right, 17-14, 2nd down and 9. We make a play. Jeremy Hill is going to try and spin and get a nice gain. That was beautiful. Baker Mayfield looking, firing, John Ross complete, and that's going to be a beautiful catch for a beautiful game. Looking for somebody open, we're going to throw to Jeremy Hill. Jeremy Hill with the catch, and he's going to pass the goal line, and we are going to get a touchdown to put the score 24-14. So we end up winning the first game with the final score, I forget, but it's like 24-17. That's a score right there. Baker Mayfield showing up and taking a job, and he could be the starter. There are questions we have to decide on at the end of this preseason as we're looking to make our final roster and finalize it. But other than that, let's move on to the second preseason game. Fumble! Fumble! And we pick it up. Vontaze Burfict for the fumble recovery, and we'll take that all day. We're going to start in LA Chargers territory. After all of that hype, it was overturned. Really? And Rivers is going to go and have plenty of time, and he's going to gunsling it, and the man is not going to get it, and that's going to bring him to a 4th down, and we hold him there. That's what we needed. Now Andy Dalton's going to start out on offense after the fumble was overturned. It's all good. We're going to look for A.J. Green, get the man some action, and he's going to truck the man and able to pick up the 1st down. That was dirty, baby. That was dirty. That's what I like to see out of my main man, A.J. Green, coming up clutch. All right, Andy Dalton going to chuck this one up to A.J. Green, the main man. He's going to come up with the catch and get us a 1st down. 2 plays in a row. This man is on fire. Here we go. Andy Dalton looking, and he's going to fire. AJ Green is so close to the first down. What's that being fourth and inches? We're going to go for it. We're going to make it happen. We're going to get my main man, Joe Mixon, the ball. We're going to throw it to him now. Joe Mixon going to catch it and not get the first. Are you kidding me? Fourth down and one. We're looking to go big. We're going to throw it, and he's going to catch it. Bryce Butler coming up clutch. Holy crap. AJ Green wide open in the middle of the field, and he's going to take it to the 12-yard line. That was a beautiful throw. Beautiful catch by AJ Green. Let's see what Joe Mixon can do, and he could have a touchdown. He's all gonna roll. No, he doesn't roll it, but so close, inches away. And that might be close, but it's all right. It's all right. Feed the ball to Joe Mixon. Joe Mixon's in, and we got 7 on the board. Baker Mayfield, it's time to step up, big boy. 4th and 20. You got to get it. You got to get it. You got to make plays here. We are looking for AJ Green. Wide open. My man, Baker Mayfield, throwing a dot. AJ Green could go all the way, and he does. AJ Green, Baker Mayfield, yo, bye-bye Andy Dalton. 64-yard touchdown. That's what I like to see. We are looking to do something. Baker Mayfield's going to keep it on his feet, and he's going to pick up a decent gain of 12 yards. Give this to Jeremy Hill. Jeremy Hill is going, and he is still pushing, and he gets a nice gain. I'll take it. I'll take that all day. John Ross! Yeah! That's my man. That's my man. 75 yards. We are coming back. Here we go. Baker Mayfield is going to find John Ross again. And that's another 75-yard touchdown. Oh, baby, is he good. Baker Mayfield, 3rd and 8. He's going to find John Ross. John Ross, touchdown. And we looking like we might win this game. All we have to do is shut him down on defense, and we will be fine. Mike. Why is open? Holy crap. We won the game. Last play of the game. My man Randall coming up clutch. Baker Mayfield throwing a dime. We got it on the final play. Remember that Minneapolis miracle? Cincinnati miracle, baby. Look at this. In preseason, throwing a dime on the final seconds of the play. Unbelievable. Holy crap. We are coming up huge. It's just a preseason game, but this is... We have to look forward to the future of Baker Mayfield. Oh, my God. Even if we miss this extra point, it doesn't matter. Look at we won the game. Look at that. Guys, leave a like on the video for that, man. Subscribe to the channel if you're new. I would appreciate it. Baker Mayfield is the future of the Cincinnati Bengals. Be on the lookout for him. He is the future. Just, if you like this series, leave a like, subscribe to the channel if you're new. Make sure you have the notification bell turned on, because this was an epic game, and you're going to miss more epic games if you don't have that notification bell turned on. So you'll get the next notification of when my video goes live. But, man, we came up clutch in the final seconds. Baker Mayfield throwing dimes. Look at this play. John Ross, touchdown. Look at this play. Here we go. Final play of the game. What a beauty. We got more. Don't worry. We got my man AJ Green going down the field from Andy Dalton. Nice play. John Ross, my man, having a great, fantastic, phenomenal day. Baker Mayfield is on fire, and you better be tuned and stay tuned for the next episode of the series, because it is just getting started. Hopefully you guys did enjoy today's episode, and I will catch you guys later. Rock Soldier 72 signing off.